Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life. Friday time, bro.
Friday time. Community post day.
It's voting day.
It's voting day.
You gotta sub, you gotta go to our channel, the community tab, and you can vote for what will come in the rotation at some point.
Because this is one of those songs.
You guys voted this in.
This is a subscriber pick song. They subscribed, they went to the community post. It is time, dude.
Dude, Bob Seger. We've been hearing his name for a minute now. A hot minute. It's been time. Y'all said, what, turn the page?
Turn the page.
Live version? What else is there to say?
Let's do it. Okay, so this song sounds like sex already.
It's a chick on a blanket kind of song. All along a lonesome highway, east of Omaha. You can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before.
That guitar line's great. Wow.
But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing much to do. And you don't feel much like riding, you just wish the trip was through.
Wow, phenomenal
dude.
Lyrics.
These vocals, too.
See, here I am.
That one
on the road again. There I am. Up on the stage. Here I go. Playing star again. There I go. Turn the page.
Ooh,
that bass note. So tasty.
Will you walk into a restaurant?
Wow, he is
strung out from the road, and you feel the eyes upon you as you're shaking off the cold. You pretend it doesn't bother you, but you just want to explode. Most times you can't hear them talk, other times you can. All the same old cliches. Is that a woman or a man? And you always seem outnumbered, you don't dare make a stand. Here I am, on the road again. There I am, up on the stage. Here I go, playing star again. There I go, turn the page. Out there the spotlight, you're a million miles away. Every ounce of energy you try to give away. As the sweat pulls out your body like the music that you play. Later in the evening as you lie awake in bed, with the echoes from the amplifiers ringing in your head, you smoke the day's last cigarette, remembering what you said. Ah, here I am, on the road again. There I am, up on the stage. Here I go, playing star again. There I go, turn the page. Ah, here I am, on the road again.
Oh my goodness.
Here I go, playing star again. There I go,
damn right you better clap for that.
All right, man, I'm gonna call it right now.
Okay.
Definitely one of the best vocalists we've heard on the channel. 100%.
I can't disagree with you. It's a different type of vocalist, but his control was impeccable.
His pitch control, his tonality. This is live, and he has the charisma style as well.
Dude, I literally have goosebumps. Like, he held back that, like, you didn't think you had it in him, or that he didn't show off that, like, grit and that snarl and that high passion that he had until the last, like, 10, 15 seconds of the song?
Yeah.
And it's like, that is mature. To know that you have it in you and you could have brought it out at any point in the song, and it's like...
He held it back.
I would rather have the lyric shine right here and then I'll shine emotionally at the very end of the climax of the song. It was so smart. It was so smart.
And just the fact that this was recorded live. Everything sounded so good. The band sounded so tight.
Oh my God, I fucking forgot it was live. It sounded so good, I forgot it was live.
Absolutely. The guitar line and the bass, dude, they're just driving it rhythmically. Wow. Super slightly. The drummer, super tasteful with the hi-hat, like... Ah, like it was just so
I literally forgot it was live.
Dude, it sounds so like it could have been a studio recording. I feel really like that's why we couldn't find a studio, because like this is like this is it. This is all it needed.
Wow. Yeah, and you were mentioning the drummer, how he was like just riding that hi-hat for just like right?
He was holding back the same way the singer was.
Yes. There was a time I mentioned it. I didn't get to finish my thought because there was so much going on.
Yep.
But he, like, while the song was going on, I said he hit the snare and I just went, "Oh, he hit the snare." Like it was something crazy. Yeah. But it was because he hit the snare like he was going to go blah and then go into something. But he just went ah and then went back to what he was doing, which is...
Yeah, I thought the drum beat was about to lock in right there as well.
And it didn't. And I was like, my God, that's so...
It was crazy. And that sax just coming in super tastefully.
Way too good.
I think this is a great entry point for Bob Seger. I think from what they've said also on the community post, the poll in the comments, they has tons of songs. This is a good entry point. Many people said one of the greatest voices of rock and roll, and so far I have to agree. I'm excited to see what else
his
he has.
Pitch control was phenomenal.
This is a beautiful ballad that brings out some grit towards the end.
Yeah.
Beautiful representation of him from just,
and again, proof that a song like this can be a banger.
It doesn't have to be ripping
the whole time. Like, the Who can be a banger, then Bob Seger can be a banger. Like, same thing.
Absolutely, man. With that, let's go and dive into some lyrics.
Be right back.
Okay, lyrics have been read.
So one of the things you mentioned in the chorus specifically, because the whole song sounds like it's talking about like a rock star, or not a rock star, just like a rock and roll player, like somebody in a band who is traveling around, playing shows, like driving long hours. But in the chorus, it says like, "Here I am on the road again, there I am up on stage, here I go, playing the star again."
And playing the star again. So I think it's important that he's noting, he's not identifying himself as a star, but more so like, he's playing the star.
He's just playing the part. He's like, "I don't feel like I'm this, but I feel like I have to pretend to be this," which is like almost sad. It's like sad in a way that's like, whether it's a lack of self-confidence or it's just realistic, like, I'm not this.
It's almost like that Rush song, Limelight, where Geddy Lee sings, you know, Neil Peart wrote it obviously, but he says like, performers and portrayers. You know, we're just people, but we're portraying and performing this idea, this feeling, this emotion, you know, the music.
Yeah, and I think... what's crazy is the lyrics of this song feel so... it's almost like a Robert Frost poem where it's so simply stated. Like, but the word choice is so specific. So like moaning, when it says like, listening to the engine...
one note song.
Moaning out a one note song, like moaning, and then it goes on to talk about sex. Like, very cool foreshadowing there. Like, one note song is a great way of describing an engine. Like,
it's the
very
same
accurate.
Sound. You're just driving for... And he said 16-hour drive.
Yep. I've driven and ridden 16 hours. It's not a fun drive. It feels like too, like he could be talking about anyone, like any performer. So whether, or even like a truck driver or like a worker on like an old, like a shift, like a welder, like working a long.
So either way, you're driving around for a job.
Yeah.
And you do not identify with the job, but you're still doing the job because that's what you do.
I even think of like a stripper, dude.
Yeah.
Like that's kind of gives, like I've known friends who have done that sort of stuff, and it's like, to me, this feels like you get home after performing and like, I can see them saying the same thing. It's like, is that a woman or a man? It's like a joking way. You have like all these people who are making fun of you the same way that this guy seems like he was being made fun of in the restaurant. It's like a very, like being on stage, I think, is the same way as like being naked a little bit. Like you're, it's very a vulnerable position.
For sure.
As like a performer. So it's like just very, very well worded.
And he sang it so well. And
so well.
You feel the emotion. Great song. Okay, what do we rate this, man? First Bob Seger song.
A+.
A+?
I think A+.
So what brings it to an A+ from an A, and what holds it back from the S? You
think? Okay, so what brings it to the A+, I think, is just the tastefulness of everything. So both vocally holding back, but also having that sauce and soar. The drummer did the same. Like, just the arrangement was all very, very mature. That being said, I feel like, and maybe it's just me being a little young and wanting some extra sauce, I feel like a little more, whether it's like a little bit longer passionate singing, or like I just wanted that more. And maybe he's way smarter than me, and it's just like he makes me want it more, and it's like I'll go back and listen to the song again. Yeah. But I feel like just a little bit more would have made it bump up to that S.
I think I'm going to give it an S.
You are?
I think there's not many songs that make me feel emotional in the way he made me feel, in terms of like,
true.
If I'm driving, like, even if it's like a 5-hour car ride, but it's at night, I don't want to be doing it. Yeah. I play the song, it makes my car ride better, you know?
Yeah. And it's like melancholy, like cathartic almost.
Yeah, and even though I probably would have wanted some more of that like grit, I feel like I appreciate the hell out of what he gave, you know?
It's facts.
To the point where it's like with the replayability, when you know it's coming, like it's almost like there's a lot of songs with certain guitar lines that you love, but they only give it to you a little bit, but then like it's mature into the sense like when you come back to it, you enjoy that section just as much, you know? Yeah. So I think it's going to be an S, but I think he's going to have more great songs that I'm
really, really excited to dive into him more. That being
absolutely,
said,
man.
Thank you guys for sticking around, all the ones who have stayed. Dude, you guys rock.
So, absolutely. Where do we go next? And we'll see you next time. Make sure to vote.
Say
peace.